Yeah, let them lift you. You feel the, yeah, you feel the loft in the spine now?
Mm-hmm.
It feels huge, huh? But do you realize how connected you are in it? Your body's going like this. But your seat bone is in the saddle. If it comes out, when your sit bone comes out, then your body quits going up because that's what it feels like to receive that. Yeah, it'll loosen up your jaw. It'll open it. You've worked a long time to open the upper path. You can do it, even if it's a big... Oh, that's fantastic. So if you get in front of it, your body feels more still. But it gets blocked right here.
For you.
So sit here, feel that lift. And what I did, when you went straight, I watched the horse's back, and it didn't hollow, it came up more. So I know that that's right. I know that's right. So feel that, then you can redirect it down your arm. Yeah, suspend your crown. Sitting trot, I want you to do a 5-6 rhythm with your breath. Oh, look at that suspension. Now let her out the top of your head, some of that energy. Uh-huh. You had it for a couple strides. Amazing. Did you feel it? Let it come all the way through your pole to your brain. Oh, there you go. You feel that? So, the healing power of a horse. There's no way we could do that by ourselves. That was good. Oh, look at her. If she could choose, she would, but that strap's there. She'd just be going, ah. I'll bet if she didn't have that nose strap, which is fine, I'm not saying she shouldn't, but she'd be going, oh, that feels fantastic. Because when you release there, all her force goes right to here, and her pole opens, she stretches down into the bit and goes, here we go. And we usually go, oh, crap. I want you to play with that, feeling that energy all the way up. Feeling the sinuses. Yeah. Better, huh? Now let it right up through the crown, because it's up to the back of your heart, but not at the pole yet, and not at the crown. Okay. If you don't receive the energy up through the upper pass and the crown, you have to set against it. This opens to receive it. And if that big power is going wham, wham on the upper pass, it's really difficult to go, oh, let me just let go. You know, it's like if the water's pushing on pushing against you, it's hard to go, oh, I'll just let go. If you're out of the way before it goes by, you can feel it. So, then get the walk before you ask for the trot. Keep this open. Keep it open. You know. Yeah, the chin back. You drop the sternum down. It's already... Oh, we got to have... I already know a good nickname, but I don't want to get whacked.
It's going to be way before he says it.
How many seconds before he says it? So, don't let your head go. Because that's kind of what's happening.
Yeah.
Let your head go like this.
Okay.
First. That's better than going, don't move my head. I'm not going to let my head go. Right? Let it bounce, because then the more you open the upper path, the more you refine it. Remember when you opened the lower back the first time and it's like, whoa, 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 it all feels wiggly? It's going to feel the same way here. Okay. There you go.
I feel like shaking each part of my body and told it to move in separate directions everywhere else.
I absolutely... Oh. Yeah. No, don't let her... Yeah, that's good. You have to have that energy at the walk and not let it be trot for her really to collect. Now, shorten the reins by 2 inches. Don't bring the elbows back anymore. Same position in your body exactly. And let her find her balance. Good, good, good. And then find that leg. Inside out. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Now you squish down that trot. Let it up to be a walk, right? When you squish it down, you still can let it up. If you want to stop it, lengthen the breath. Lift the toes a little bit. Instead of hunkering down.
Yes.
So that's it's another, you know, you're
knocking off the rough edges.
Well, you've knocked off the rough edges. Now we're just polishing. There you go. Keep that forward walk. Yeah, feel that movement up in your spine. Open the back of your heart. Oh, now keep that forward walk. There you go. Now open the heart. Remember, it's like creating and receiving and then redirecting that energy. Not creating it and then letting the body do the old thing. Oh, squeeze against it. The back looks good, Lorna. Can you feel it? Okay,
yeah.
I got you. And remember, the freeing up the Ming Mung is like opening the main gate. Then you can start, then you let the power in to feel the other gates, the back of the heart, the Chi Hui's. Yeah, you let the rein slip longer. And again, we're not shortening the reins because of her. We're shortening them because of us, right? So we can feel there. You feel her stretch down into it?
Yeah.
And that's when I pulled on your hands, right? And I said, let that pull come in. See, because she's young, when she's in this carriage, she's like, oh, I want to trot.
Yeah.
When she doesn't trot, she really has to lift with her back more to keep this walk. So it's fantastic training. You know, you feel her pull. See if that pull can stretch your back, can fill your back. There you go. There we go. You feel her stretching down into the bit?
Yeah.
Now, if she stretches down and you pull up, she's going to raise her head again. So this is like a beautiful conversation. It's a dance. When you're right, she'll stretch down, and then you have to be able to let her pull your back up and open your heart more with that pull. And then she'll stay there. And if you miss it, the only thing that's going to happen, she'll lift her head up. There you go. Just those few strides. Yeah, see, she's going to find her balance with it. If you don't pull against her, but you don't let her change your position. There you go. Make sure. That's the only way you're gonna stay balanced is. Good, and let the reins go 2 inches and give her a pat. Oh, good. Yeah, circle right here. The outside shoulder come a little bit more. Oh, that was a lot more. Half that much. There you go. Oh, yeah. Now, floppy in the arms or no?
Well done. We thought it was great.
I think it's fantastic.